Hello and welcome. In today's lesson, we will practice drawing Lewis structures of polyatomic molecules, molecules with three or more atoms, but relatively simple polyatomic molecules with just one central atom. When I teach my class how to draw Lewis structures of these molecules, I do it in a very systematic approach by teaching them these four or five steps that they can always follow that allow them to determine what the Lewis structure is for a particular molecule. And the idea of a Lewis structure is to get at least a two-dimensional representation of what the molecule actually physically looks like. And from there, of course, in future chapters, we'll talk about how that then helps us predict some of the physical and chemical behavior of these molecules. So in the first step in drawing a Lewis structure is to simply count how many total number of valence electrons the molecule or the ion actually has. Because in drawing Lewis structures, we want to, in one way or the other, distribute the total number of valence electrons in such a way that the octet rule is satisfied for the elements, for all atoms of the molecule, with the exception of hydrogen, where only the duet rule needs to be satisfied. So recall that for these main group elements, the group number tells us exactly how many valence electrons that atom has. So we take a look at carbon. We have one carbon atom. From the periodic table, we can see then that carbon is in group 4. So because it's in group 4, each carbon atom will contribute 4 valence electrons. So 1 times 4, 1 carbon times 4 valence electrons each, plus 3 hydrogens. Hydrogen is in group 1a. Because hydrogen is in group 1a, each hydrogen atom is going to contribute 1 valence electron. And then finally, the fluorine, we have just the one fluorine atom. The one fluorine atom, because fluorine is in group 7a, the fluorine atom contributes 7 valence electrons. And the group number is the same as the number of valence electrons. So then step one, counting how many total number of valence electrons I have in this molecule, would be 4 plus 3 plus 7, or a total of 14 valence electrons. Then all subsequent steps, starting step two, I want to distribute then those 14 valence electrons in such a way to satisfy the octet rule or the duet rule. So in step two, I need to start basically building the skeletal structure of my molecule, basically figuring out what's called the connectivity of my molecule. Connectivity is how the atoms are actually physically connected or bonded to one another, whether atom A is connected to atom B, which is then connected to atom C, or is it atom A is connected to atom C, which is then connected to atom B, etc. When we're first starting out, step two can be really the source of most of our serious error, but following these relatively simple, or keeping in mind at least, these rules of thumb will help us eliminate a lot of those errors. The first rule of thumb says that the hydrogen atoms and fluorine atoms are never going to be central atoms, which is especially relevant for our structure, because if we take a look back at our structure, we notice that in our molecules formula, we only have hydrogen, fluorine, which can never be central atoms, so that leaves carbon that must be then the central atom, just as through a process of elimination. So carbon is our central atom, carbon is our atom in the middle, and then we'll assume that all the other atoms, the other four atoms then, are connected in one way or the other to that central atom. So we'll have the three hydrogen atoms, and they have to be at least connected to the central carbon atom via a single covalent bond. It may not be the actual connectivity, but it's at least the minimal connectivity to get this structure. Determine what the connectivity is of this molecule. We have carbon in the middle, carbon is the central atom, and then bonded to that central carbon atom are the other four atoms. In step three, then, I want to sort of take a sort of step back, sort of pause my approach, and determine how many valence electrons have I used up, how many valence electrons remain unassigned. So to do that, I want to first recall that I start off with 14 valence electrons. And then drawing, in step two is drawing, and drawing those four single covalent bonds, I've used, remember each single covalent bond represents two valence electrons, I've used up eight of my original 14 valence electrons simply by adding the minimal connectivity to my central carbon atom. In other words, I've used eight of them, I started with 14, so in other words, 14 minus 8 means I have this point in my structure. I have six valence electrons that I've yet to account for, I've yet to assign. In step four, then, I then want to distribute any remaining or unassigned valence electrons as lone pairs to any atom that has yet to satisfy the octet rule or the duet rule for any hydrogen atom. So before I really get into this step, I like to do is redraw my structure from step two. So we'd have carbon, hydrogen, hydrogen. And I do this to see how my structures progress as I've gone through these systematic steps. So basically starting the structure I have from step two. And then notice I have six valence electrons remaining, so I want to keep that in mind. Looking carefully at my structure, I want to see if I've satisfied the octet rule for all the elements except for hydrogen, which I only need to satisfy the duet rule. So hydrogen atoms first, they only want to satisfy the duet rule, which means only need to have exactly two electrons. Just with my step two structure, I have satisfied the duet rule, rather, for hydrogen, this hydrogen, as well as this hydrogen. For the carbon in the middle, it has satisfied the octet rule. It has ownership of eight valence electrons. But notice for the fluorine, currently it only has ownership of two valence electrons. It needs ownership to gain somehow the ownership of six additional electrons in order to satisfy the octet rule. Notice that at the end of step three, my accounting step, I have six valence electrons remaining, so it makes sense to simply assign those six valence electrons to the fluorine atom. So notice that in doing so, I've used 100% of my valence electrons, 14 valence electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and I have distributed those 14 valence electrons in such a way to satisfy the duet rule for the hydrogens, and then the octet rule for the carbon and the fluorine. So my structure at the end of step four is a perfectly valid structure, Lewis structure, for a molecule with the formula of CH3F.